In the early 20th century, Japan was the only country in East Asia which was able to successfully modernize its army and navy and decisively defeat a major European power in a war. As a result, Japan in the early 20th century was seen as a model, was seen as an example to follow for many Chinese nationalists who were looking to modernize China. Many Chinese students were sent to Japan to study military science and military doctrine. Among these Chinese students was a young Chiang Kai-shek, who would later become the future president of the Republic of China. In the winter of 1910, Chiang Kai-shek was enlisted in the field artillery of the 19th Regiment, 13th Division of the Takata Army in Japan as a private second class, the lowest rank in the army. At the time, Chiang Kai-shek was 23 years old. Chiang Kai-shek in his writings described his time in the Japanese army as very tough. Every morning after waking up, Chiang Kai-shek was tasked with washing and feeding all of the horses in the entire regiment. Every single horse had to be washed, every single horse had to be fed. Chiang was not allowed to eat breakfast until this task was completed. Meals in the Imperial Japanese Army consisted of very little food. Every soldier was only allowed one bowl of rice per meal, with a side dish of maybe salted fish or radish. All of the food was served cold. Even if the soldiers were starving, even if the soldiers did not have enough to eat, they would not be allowed more than one bowl of rice per meal. Chiang Kai-shek struggled very hard during his first month of enlistment, but eventually he did adapt to this diet and he did adapt to this lifestyle. Coldness left a very deep impression on the young Chiang Kai-shek. Chiang Kai-shek came from southern China. In southern China, the weather is usually very hot or very warm. The weather in Japan was completely different. The weather in Japan was very cold. During the wintertime, it snowed very heavily in Takeda. When Chiang Kai-shek was in Japan, he and the rest of the soldiers in his regiment would wash their face with cold water every morning after waking up. In the evening, Chiang and the rest of the Japanese soldiers in his regiment would take baths in ice cold water, or they would wash themselves with snow. Chiang Kai-shek believed that washing the body with cold water or with snow strengthened the spirit, the mind, and the body. Chiang Kai-shek in his later memoirs wrote that he was not physically strong when he first came to Japan to study. But after 1 month of enduring cold baths and enduring the cold weather and eating very little food, his body became stronger and stronger. His spirit became more and more healthy. The cold baths, the starvation, the poor living conditions in the Japanese army made Chiang Kai-shek's life very difficult. But Chiang Kai-shek did not complain. Instead, Chiang Kai-shek wrote in his diary that it was actually the happiest days of his life, and he tried to work very hard to learn as much as possible to strengthen himself. This is the hard process of self-cultivation, Chiang Kai-shek wrote. Chiang Kai-shek was greatly impressed by the Japanese military education. First of all, Chiang Kai-shek was very fascinated by the strict discipline and by the strict military culture. Chiang Kai-shek noted that in Japan, the senior officers placed a very huge emphasis on cleanliness, order, and sanitation. The keeping of discipline was connected to cleanliness and sanitation. Chiang Kai-shek greatly admired the Japanese military code and the imperial mandate for the Japanese military. This mandate stressed that every single soldier must be loyal to the country, respect justice and bravery, live modestly, and live austerely. The Japanese military culture at the time was in stark contrast to the Chinese military. In the early 20th century, the Chinese military was not united. Chinese army was under control of rival generals and rival warlords fighting each other over control of different regions in the country. Chinese soldiers were poorly trained and ill-disciplined. So when Chiang Kai-shek returned to China in 1911, when he went back to China, he tried to use what he learned from his experiences in Japan to understand China's weaknesses and to strengthen the country. Chiang Kai-shek's goal, his dream, was to create a strong national army in China. He wanted to build a strong China with a strong army which will be able to wipe out the humiliation that China suffered, to save the country and to achieve China's independence. Eventually, Chiang Kai-shek became the leader of the Republic of China, and he led China to victory in the Second World War.